friends, I know, with dear young engineers, the products of Vijnan Institute of Information Technology, Visakhapatnam. We are all proud of you. At the outset, I congratulate you for the successful completion of this four-year engineering course. More than 90% of you, I am sure that you will receive the degrees in the near future, and you have completed the course very successfully. And out of that, more than 80% of you got the placements also, you know, very well. And it is the, I think it is the best number in this area. So I really congratulate you for the completion of the course as well as for getting the placement. And if you remember, or if you go back four years, at the introduction itself, when you are admitted into this college, we have promised something to you and your parents. We are going to give you the knowledge required, and we don't be satisfied, or we don't limit our job is only to give the knowledge. We are going to give the good, right personalities, good personalities to lead a very happy life. So, the other components beyond the knowledge, what we have given is, I don't know, by this time you must have grasped that, it is the communication we have given extremely well by designing lots of courses, and also the social quotient, that is interpersonal relations among the students and also between the students and the teachers, and also the social perception, understanding the social problems and other aspects by some of you must have involved in many many activities like NSS, NCC and other things. So the managerial skills and organization skills. So these things are not there in your curriculum actually, but without your knowledge itself, without your consciousness, we have developed, made into a very a different program to develop all these things. So the organization skills and managerial skills, they are developed by conducting many programs on the campus. All of you are aware that on an average, we have conducted at least one program every month where most of you have participated. And you know how to organize a program, how to build a program, how to interact others, how to interact elders, how to interact the guests, all these things in the process, without your knowledge, without your consciousness, you have developed that. So with all these things, I am sure that we have produced not only knowledgeable engineers, but who are psychologically strong and emotionally balanced with social consciousness. This is the kind of total personality anybody is expecting. We have done our best to do that. And to make it happen, you being the students, you have cooperated all through the last 4 years. It's very interesting to tell you, we are so good. In the last 4 years, not even one issue has happened on this institute, on this campus. Not even one unrest element among the students has happened. Not even one untoward incident was happened. So this all shows how we have developed time to time. And gradually we have entered here just like that as an intermediate student, do not know big deals or big things and no maturity kind of thing. After entering over here, you have developed knowledge, communication and good relations and ultimately developed a good personality to behave well in any suitable to an organization. This is an extremely good thing, a very happy situation. In fact, all of you are aware, in many government universities, in many big universities also, there are issues once in 3 months, once in 6 months. We didn't find even one issue in the last 4 years. That will exemplify your good behavior. And it will illustrate your the maturity. This is exactly what an institute has to do, not simply transfer of knowledge. What is the kind of people we are preparing, giving it to the society? So we have done our best. Maybe some small lapses also might be there. You are patient enough to accept all those things, and you are good enough to do these and take good things to your side, and you have grown very well. Ultimately, it was done well. So what all we have promised on the day one when we have entered into this campus, we have fulfilled all those promises, if not 100%, to the extent of 90%. So this is how the institute also has done its best. And I really thank you for your decent behavior, a matured behavior, and really, especially when you have taken the final year examinations after the corona pandemic. You have behaved, your attendance is more than 99, I know that. So not only the attendance, the way you behaved on the campus after the pandemic or during the crisis, the way you have taken the examinations, the way you have greeted your friends and teachers, it is exemplary. This is exactly what we wanted, or any institute wanted, this kind of thing. So once again, thank you for your decent behavior all these 4 years. Now you are entering into the life. Yes, this is the very important thing. So any institute prepares a student for the examination, it is a failure institute, from my perception. Yes, if any institute prepares a student for his life, that's the best institute. That's a good institute. So we have prepared you for the life, I'm sure. So you are entering into the life. So especially most of you, as I told you, 80% of you are going to enter into your jobs. It's a new place, new anyone, a totally new thing. So far in the last 15 years, you are in the schooling, under the conditioned environment, under somebody's instruction. Now you are on your own. You have to grow on your own. You have to behave in your own. You have to know what is right, wrong, every moment. Not once in a while. Every moment you have to decide what is right and wrong. So try to behave in an organized way, in any organization, so that you can grow better, you can grow faster. So how to behave yourselves in an organization? Naturally, once you are given a job, you will be given some training, how to do a job and all that. After 2-3 months, you will be put, shown a chair and asked you to do that job. Fine, you do that job, you excel that. So not only about the training, you try to do something more than the training. Yes, everywhere, the 90% of the knowledge in the world is available online. So nobody can stop you to learn more things. Yes, try to learn in that area and try to do better things. What beyond your training, beyond what they are expecting. Yes, that is the first thing you have to do. You can learn in no time. If they give 3 months training, you can learn beyond the training, you can learn in 10 days, better knowledge, better things. You should know better than your manager. That's the first thing you should do. But at the same time, you should be obedient to your manager. Don't expect your extra knowledge and overconfidence before your superiors. You have to make out a balance between the two. I'm telling you two controversial things. Gain more knowledge, but don't expect it. But expect it when it is required, when it is asked for. Then you'll be treated very well. Don't expect it every time, everywhere, especially with the superiors. Then, yes, that is the first thing you should understand at the workplace. And then the second thing is, not only completing your work successfully, see the team members. If anybody is behind you or anybody is not doing that well, try to help them without asking. So try to help them. That makes you a better team member. Don't limit. You are given an assignment and given a time up to 5 o'clock. You have completed at 2:30, and without help others, that makes some sense. You have some strength, and other fellow who is not that good at work also will have some strength. So that is it. We have to learn at your workplace. That is the most important. And the third thing is, yes, you have to maintain some decency in the conversation, the language you use, the behavior you expect, and the way you dress. All these things try to maintain the decency, so that somebody should ask and identify you that this boy is very decent. He should be from India. That is the kind of, without any label, without anything, they should identify you by your behavior. That is the kind of behavior you have to expect. Then your growth would be better. Not only for Vignan's this thing, then the decency makes you, gives you a lot of strength and makes you do better. So that is the wonderful thing you can make of. And don't stop your learning. See, what we are doing is, in the last 4 years, we have given 30 subjects, 28 subjects kind of thing. You are going to work only out of the 30 subjects, only on one subject. That is the requirement. That's it. But what is the rest of the 29 subjects? But it adds maturity and other things. But now your job is, that is the whole difference between a student and an employee. Your job is, after selecting a particular subject, after when we are working a particular subject, you have to do kind of research on that subject. There should be a continuous learning. Once you stop the learning, you are irrelevant. You are irrelevant. Mind you, that knowledge is being doubled for every 5 years. Every 5 years. So whatever the knowledge, especially during this century, whatever the knowledge we have got it in the last 100 years, the equal amount of knowledge we got it in the last 10 years. Yes, that is the speed with which the knowledge is growing. You have to catch up that speed. Yes, once you stop learning, you are irrelevant. Nobody bothers about it. Nobody offers anything, no growth, nothing will be there. That is the reason some of your seniors who are working in your same organization from the last 10-15 years are asked to leave the organization. The reason is not for this, they have not updated themselves. Yes, so the 21st century's buzzword is change. You have to change continuously by improving your knowledge. Yes, once you enter, what is your knowledge level? After 6 months, the knowledge level need to be improved to the next level. After 1 year, you will be totally a different fellow. That is the way, that is the pace with which you have to improve your knowledge. Otherwise, you will become totally irrelevant. Yes. Totally irrelevant. So, all of you, most of you are joined in IT companies. That growth is like this. So, there won't be very few activities of humankind in the next 5 years without the interference of artificial intelligence. Yes. There will be artificial teachers, artificial intelligence drivers, artificial AI doctors, AI engineers, everything would be, everywhere artificial intelligence would be interfered. So you now, as such, you know the basics of computers. Now you have to build towards that, otherwise it will be irrelevant. So when a doctor has come, entered into the, about 20-30 years back, all the regular police are irrelevant. Those who learn the driving of tractor become relevant. Otherwise, those who are digging in the same way doing it, they are irrelevant. That is, they are substituted by tractor. Same way you are going to see the scenario in the next future. So we try to continuously in the mode of change. What is the change in me in the last 3 months? change in me in the last 6 months. So that is the way you have to make up your mind. And don't be, naturally when IT people are, you are going to get 40,000-50,000 rupees and you work for 5-6 hours, you go for a pub and you enjoy it and have good friends and all that. That's okay. I'm not disputing all these things. But to do all these things, but be conscious of it, so improve, spend at least two and a half hours every day to improve your knowledge. Otherwise, it will become totally irrelevant. Totally irrelevant. In the last, of course, now the companies are removing the people who are working 10-15 years experienced people. In the next phase, they are going to remove after 3-4 years. You should not be one among them. You should be the fellow who are going to the next level. So for that you need to, the best word is the change. If you are trying, you have to change. That is what is required. And the last thing is, some of you must have given birth to God placements in very small companies, for a very small salaries also. So for 15,000, 20,000, less than 20,000. They must be worrying a lot. So other my friends they got 40,000-50,000 rupees. I got only 50,000-20,000 rupees. Whether I join there or not, if I join, with what kind of mood I have to work? This is the kind of questions you must be entertaining. So this is a, in a way, this is you are in a most advantageous position. Okay, advantage. Yeah, you are getting 20,000 rupees, whereas the other fellow is getting 50,000. How can you be in the advantage position? That must be your question. I say repeatedly, you are in the most advantageous position. How this advantage? It is up to you to take this advantage. Suppose you got a job in TCS or Infosys. You are given a particular module, a particular task, a simple task. And that you do it and you will get the salary. Fine. That is one way. The second way is, you are given a job of 20,000 in a company of only 15 members. When a company of 15 members, you know everything. So they are the people who are developing the new idea. You are the part of new idea. They are the people who are trying to make it a product. You are the part of the making the product. They are the people to sell that product. You are the part of marketing. They are bothered about the finances, raising of it. You are part of it. You will know many things, many skills apart from your regular thing. You will have a great advantage if you work 2-3 years in that small companies. Don't feel bad of yourselves, and it's an advantage. So you will know everything in 2-3 years. You will know what is the technology idea, what is the product, and how to develop a product, what is the marketing, what is the fair? Four essential things for a 21st century fellow to grow. So don't hesitate whether to join or not. You join and work seriously. Develop a passion towards your work and to your company. Never think that you have to grow on your own. Never you grow on your own. You have to grow with the growth of your company. So that is the mind with which this company should grow better. I should be the part of it. I should get the benefit of it. This is the way you should approach yourselves and make yourselves happy. As the last suggestion to make yourselves happy in the life, I am sure that you are going to marry after 2-3 years. So when you marry, before the marriage, now you must have boys and girls, you have friends and all that. Now you must have departed one another. A few of them must be continuing their friendship, fine. So if both of you got settled and if you like each other, fine, you convince your parents and get it done. But all the other people maybe go with the arranged marriages or the suggestions of the parents and all that. Yeah, before the marriage, yes, at your age, whenever you see a girl or a boy, beautiful, she is beautiful and he is handsome, all these things happen. But after the marriage, 10, 50 days, 20 days, yes, your attraction will go down and you are going to find fault with others. Whether a male or a boy or girl going to find fault with others, there the problems, many problems, it may go to a large extent, unavoidable extent also. That's the reason I'm telling. Remember my boys and girls, any human being is with some deficiencies, with all strengths, but with some deficiencies also. Before the marriage, you see only the strength, his skin color, this, that and all that, and property, this, that and all that. But after the marriage, you realize that his attitude is not right, he is not thinking properly, he is not caring properly, all these things would come after 10-15 days. You start disliking it and sometimes it goes to a large extent also. Remember, I am again telling, any human being is with big strengths and also with small deficiencies. You have to love your partner with all the deficiencies, not with strengths. So yes, so if he is black, you have to love the blacker. If he is short, you have to love the short. Yes. If he eats more, you have to love that part. So that is the kind of thing. Don't create disliking. Some aberrations are there for any human being. So start liking those deficiencies, then your life will be happy. I hope and I wish that you're not only getting a job or getting a money, your life will be happy. That would be there when your family life is happy. So wish you all the best. Good luck.